Hello, Scorpio. Welcome to Truth Well Told Tarot. This is Andrea, Rhea for short, and I'm here to do your October 2020 tarot reading for the sign of Scorpio, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. So let's get straight into your reading and pull your overarching message, your energy. What do we have for Scorpio, please, angel spirits guides? And this is for October 2020. Message for Scorpio, thank you. I love this. We've got the Three of Cups. Okay, message for Scorpio, please. What does Scorpio need to hear? Thank you. October 2020, Angel Spirits Guides. What does Scorpio need to hear? Thank you. Thank you. Okay. We have grace and gratitude. Through gratitude, joy expands. Feels it's linked with this three of cups. It feels like you're going to have something to be thankful for. See what else we get. What do we have, please, angels, spirits, guides? What is the message for our lovely Scorpios? Thank you. Don't stop. I feel some of you might be giving up or feeling things are getting on top of you. This is a great energy when that, to really combat that energy when we feel that way. Okay, Scorpio, so I pull five cards. The first card is the past position. Second card is the present position. Third is your challenge. Fourth, advice from spirit. And the fifth is your outcome. Then we clarify the cards and go deeper into the message. And it won't resonate with everybody. So as always, just take what resonates with you. First card out is the Seven of Cups. Okay. This is your past position. Temperance card of Sagittarius is your present. The Knight of Swords is your challenge. High Priestess is advice from spirit. And your outcome, Scorpio, we have the Knight of Pentacles. I mean, this is beautiful. Okay. Message for Scorpio, please. It's interesting, I've got the King of Pentacles with the Six of Wands. I feel that there's some kind of achievement here this month. I really do. Feels very much in that vein. Some sense of achievement that you're feeling good about. Message for Scorpio, please. Thank you. Seven of Swords. Temperance is clarified by justice. The Three of Pentacles clarifies the Knight of Swords. Seven of Wands clarifies the High Priestess. And the Knight of Pentacles is clarified by the Five of Swords. Bottom of the deck, I have the Devil here. What is this devil? Let me get a clarifier. What is this devil for Scorpio, please, angels, spirits, guides? What is this devil for Scorpio, thank you? What is this devil? Thank you. I've got the Five of Swords again. Clarify this justice. What is this justice? Thank you. It's a card of Libra. Other signs on the table, we've got Sagittarius, Gemini, Virgo. Okay, so it's linked with the Magician. Okay, Scorpio. I'm gonna pull a card. I'm gonna do the Tarot of Dreams as well. Let's clarify this Three of Cups first as well. Let's clarify this Three of Cups. For Scorpio, please. Okay, so it's judgment. It feels like there's some karma around you, Scorpio. You know, the judgment card is a card of karma. Certainly with this justice card as well, I certainly feel for some of you, it feels that you haven't been treated in a fair way. And it definitely is aligning with money and career for me as a reader. But the good thing is that I do feel this month there is a positive change. There will be something to celebrate. You will find some sense of achievement. There's going to be an achievement that you're going to feel good about. And it's going to allow you to release whatever this devil was or whoever this devil was. And it feels very much in terms of your money, career, business. Now, remember, we can also be our own demons. We can also be our own jailers. We can also keep ourselves in that shadow phase, feeling negative, focusing on the negative, that forms a barrier, an actual physical barrier that stops us from moving forwards and achieving and getting where we want to go. So in that energy, I feel like this is another person though, another person that you've been disagreeing with. It feels like there may have been some kind of decision or something that wasn't fair. And the eyes of the universe is on it because I've got two cards of karma here. So there's a powerful message that give it up to the universe. It's time to let go. It is time for you to step in your light and move forward. It's a powerful awakening because there will be reasons to celebrate. Again, this Three of Cups is a wonderful energy of a sense of achievement coming your way. You're going to be celebrating something. And I do think it's in terms of money and career, which will allow you to close one door and open another. Remember, three in tarot is about manifesting something new. So I'm really feeling this energy quite strongly. There's a lot of karma around you because I really am feeling that some of you haven't been treated fairly in a situation. The message is don't stop, don't let anything stop you. And again, this is where I'm also feeling we can be our own worst demons. We can also be our own saboteurs. So there is a feeling here that, and again, this grace and gratitude, you will be thankful for something, I feel. Don't stop, keep going, because it's coming your way. And that's what I'm feeling the energy of, this sense of achievement, feeling good about something, allowing yourself to close one phase out of your life and break difficult cycles, bad cycles, karmic cycles, even. It is this energy of you will be putting something behind you this month as well. So interesting energy. I mean, I will also say, Scorpio, that this devil could represent the pandemic too, because it is Saturnian energy. It is that energy of where you've been tested. So it might well be in terms of your money and career, you have been tested. You've been feeling the pressure, you've been feeling the restraints, you've been feeling the challenges. Things may have changed in the workplace, either job losses or restructuring or changes in your role, all because of the pandemic as well. So I mean, it's not limited to that, but I do feel that it's coming to me as that Saturnian energy as well. So I'm kind of feeling for some of you that you will have this opportunity to put it behind you. But first and foremost, I am still feeling this karma around you. It definitely feels like for some of you, there's been some unfairness here, something that wasn't fair. Now, something wasn't fair, so maybe in the past you've been secretly looking at opportunities, keeping your options open in money and career because of maybe changes or being treated unfairly in your work environment, your money career as well. Maybe you could see something coming. There's an intuitive energy here. So I'm just kind of feeling in this energy, maybe you are keeping your options open here, making clear choices on how you need to move forward now, instinctively. Instinctively, things are changing. Instinctively, that you need to adapt to this kind of experience that you've been feeling here. And you might have been keeping things under the radar, keeping things to yourself here. It feels like that hidden strategy, of keeping your options open. Looking maybe for new jobs, new positions, how you move forward in a situation. Because the Temperance card, it can come after the Death card. So the Death card can be about change, deep change. It can also be about endings. So there have been some deep changes that maybe haven't been fair or endings, job losses maybe. And this is where you're understanding how to adapt. I'm feeling this adapt. The Temperance energy is making peace with something by getting a deeper understanding of your situation and how you need to adapt your beliefs, your outlook in order to find your flow again, it's a wonderful energy of learning from experience as you go, and how that almost kind of like makes you adjust your perceptions to understand this is how I need to adapt to a changing environment here. This is how I need to make those changes in my life to actually find my flow again and get things moving, So it is that energy of finding your flow, making peace with situations, trying to get that balance back in your life, in order to just move forward. Now, I love the fact that the magician is here. Because again, the justice energy is about balance as well. It's a Libra energy. I mean, if there's been some, the justice can be to do with legal systems. If something wasn't unfair, you might have gone to a tribunal here. You may have got an arbiter involved, that type of thing. It can also be about doing the right thing, and I feel for you, it's doing the right thing for you now. How you need to adapt to this situation and do the right thing for you. I can't get out of my mind that there has been something unfair about a situation here. It's either caused by the pandemic or it's caused by somebody in particular that you work with. And the justice energy is karma. It's cause and effect. Every action has a consequence, whether it's positive feedback or negative feedback from the universe. So in this instance, you are being told, it's almost like if you're waiting for a legal decision, it feels for some of you, it's time to put this justice situation behind you. Find your balance and manifest a new path. Change something that has been negative to something that is positive here, Scorpio, because you have the power. When the magician appears, you have the power within you to bring change. Positive change to something that may have been a negative experience here. And what you put into something now is very much linked with the law of attraction, is what you'll get back. So put your energy in the right direction, and that's why Temperance is just kind of saying make peace with what's gone. Again, I'm feeling that there's been, I can't get away from some kind of shadow here, whatever this represents. I'm feeling it quite strongly, but in this situation, the magician is, it's time to unfold this new path. You have the power within you, the magic within you and around you, the talents, the earthly tools on the table, earth, air, fire, and water, combined with the divine energy within you and around you to manifest something new. He changes something that is base metal into gold. And it feels like you're considering how you need to take action to transform your situation that you don't think is either fair or doesn't suit you anymore. And you need to adapt. You need to make some changes here. And you're getting clarity in how you need to do that. Interestingly, the Knight of Swords, It might well be for some of you that you found it difficult to find progress in a situation that you've been trying to manifest something new. You might have been working on this for a while. I mean, the Three of Pentacles can be to do with, it can be to do with teamwork, collaboration, getting a business venture off the ground, and it's almost kind of like things might not have been happening. You might have been doing this below the surface here, below the radar. You might have also been trying to manifest a new job, a new career, call it what you will. With this Three of Pentacles, again, the three is about manifesting something new. It doesn't feel like it's been happening as quickly as you want it to. Certainly with the Knight of Swords in the challenge position, it's just not been moving as quickly as you wanted it to, Scorpio, in this instance. And the message here is there can be a bit of unfocused energy in the challenge position. The Knight of Swords is extremely focused, very clear in his mind on how he needs to move forward now. And with this magician energy, there is a message of, and again, there's a bit of unfocused energy here with the Seven of Cups. Which way do I go? I'm keeping my options open. I have a number of avenues that I want to explore. I mean, you might be applying for jobs on the internet as well, but I'm kind of feeling in this energy that there's a need to focus here in order to manifest this success. Focus on one thing in particular, on what you want to transform, because that magician energy is clear intention. It's focused intention. That's how you bring the transformation. And again, this Three of Pentacles is focus, prioritize. Get advice where you need it to. Some of you might be getting loans as well to kind of like even set up your own business. This can also be about, I mean, even property developing. It can be to do with working hard on manifesting a new career, new job as well. But it doesn't seem to have been as quick as you wanted it to be here, Scorpio. And I'm getting a sense of a lack of focus here. And again, the magician is saying, you need to focus. You need to have this clear intention on how to move forward in a situation. And it's almost kind of like this imbalance has been causing you to feel unfocused. And that's what that Temperance energy does. It is find that balance again. Find the way through the kind of like choppy waters here, the extreme emotions, the extremes of the situation. It's finding that middle road on how you sail through and find your flow. Because we have the High Priestess. So the High Priestess and the Seven of Wands. I mean, the High Priestess is a card of your soul truth. It's a card of your true light, your true essence. It is how spirit speaks to you through your soul. It's like this soul path is you're being guided toward your soul path here through your intuition here. So it is about trusting your instincts, align with your inner light. It's also a big message if you are being deeply guided here, Scorpio, and protected. Because again, we have the we have the Seven of Wands here. Some of you might be competing. I mean, I've got three sevens, which is a really magical master number. You are being given divine assistance. And again, with the High Priestess, I've just noticed that three sevens. I mean, this is a really powerful energy if you are being powerfully guided. There's a message of you will get on higher ground than the competition that you might be up against. It feels that you might be competing for a job, and this is about stay at it, don't stop, keep going. This is somebody who perseveres, who sees something through, who is in their power, who has the will and the determination to succeed, even though the odds are stacked against them. They have six wands against one person. There's six people against one person here, and yet this person is on higher ground, and you know who's going to win. It's going to be that person. So even though the odds seem overwhelming, even though things seem stacked against you, the message is that you are getting the advantage on top of this situation, even though you don't realize it. This Five of Swords, Scorpio, and the outcome. The Five of Swords is interesting. Let me just pull one for this. I'm going to pull a clarifier for this Knight of Pentacles. Can we clarify this Knight of Pentacles, please, Angel Spirits Guides? Let's clarify this Knight of Pentacles for Scorpio, thank you. Yeah, I've got death. So again, the Death card comes before the Temperance in the Major Arcana, and here we have this Death card. I feel for some of you, it is the Knight of Pentacles is a delivery, it's an opportunity. And it feels like there's going to be some transformative change here in your situation. I mean, in a positive way, because this is Scorpio energy. This is you. So you're coming out with this Knight of Pentacles. This is either you focusing on how you bring an opportunity into your life, in which case the Knight of Pentacles is somebody offering you an opportunity. And remember, this is the golden opportunity that the Magician is bringing into you. There's a message here, Scorpio, also, that there may well be what you've been working hard towards. You may be getting some money coming your way. It might well be what you might have been owed from this justice as well. So it might well be some money is coming your way as well. It feels like there is incoming abundance, incoming success when the Knight of Pentacles arrives. It's been long awaited. But it's something that is transforming, bringing positive change, I feel, to your situation. Allowing you to close one door and open another. I love the fact that your card has come over this, because this is where you're at. It's the long-awaited opportunity. Things may not have been or moved as quickly as you wanted them to, and it might well be to do with the pandemic. It's not limited to that, but it might well be to do with that, Scorpio. But I do feel for some of you, this is where you are the Phoenix rising. You are allowing yourself to rise in your own light with this opportunity, I feel, for some of you. The only thing that's standing in your way is this Five of Swords energy, which is a distracting energy. And this is why I'm talking about your focus, because there's a feeling of negative thinking, but it can also be about bad feeling, arguments, conflict. And there's a message here, because it's an Aquarian energy, you need to see past this situation now. You need to ask yourself, is it worth it? Is it worth focusing your mind on this? Because it is blocking this coming into you. And I do feel for some of you, there is an opportunity coming into you that will be reasons to celebrate, that will allow you to move on from some disagreement or some bad feeling that you had, either about a situation or towards somebody. The devil can be somebody. It can also be, obviously, a situation, like I said. It can be about toxic relationships. It can be to do with somebody who manipulates, somebody who, I mean, it's the ego as well. I kind of feel in this instance, Scorpio, I mean, it can be about something that is unhealthy, that is causing you great instability. And the Knight of Pentacles is this opportunity to bring greater stability and security and success into your life. So there's a big message of don't focus on what is going to bring you instability now, when stability, almost opportunity, is coming into your world right now. It's a powerful, powerful energy here. It feels like you might have had an argument or a disagreement. I mean, that could be a boss, a work colleague. Something feels like it wasn't fair in this situation, because I've got a lot of karma in this reading. But there is a feeling here, Scorpio, that you are going to get an opportunity coming your way. So make sure you're focusing on that clear intention. Don't focus, because this is the two fives and it's the Five of Swords, it's to do with your mind, where you're putting your focus, where you're putting your attention. And remember, this Knight of Swords is that shift, it's progress. It is change, and it's to do with the mind, and that is the greatest challenge, I feel, for some of you. It's where you focus that energy right now, and your mental energy, your thoughts. Because this is the only thing that's going to stand in your way, I feel. But I do feel that there is a great energy of an opportunity coming your way that is going to bring deep transformation to your situation. It's a beautiful energy. I mean, you know, this Knight of Pentacles can also be, I mean, like I said, jobs, could be to do with getting some money coming your way, could also be to do with even client wins. But either way, just make sure you're focusing in the right area here. And there is a message that if you do, you step into your light, there will be reasons to celebrate. There will be something to be thankful for. It's a beautiful, beautiful energy, the Three of Cups, of celebration. But you know, it is an energy of the winter is over, the spring is here. I'm receiving my bounty. I'm receiving my harvest for all my hard work here. It feels, you know, there's an energy of things are beginning to grow, things are beginning to move again. And I think it's to do with what this Knight of Pentacles is bringing into you. It's a really lovely energy here. Okay, so I'm going to pull a final card. Final message for Scorpio, please. Thank you. Oh, wow. Stepping into your power, we have the Frog. Don't take a back seat in your story. It's time to step up. The only thing that I will say, Scorpio, is that focus. And I think if there's that mental focus on how you're bringing progress and what you're working towards and getting that clarity and that focused intention, everything falls into place because there's so much karma around you. It is almost kind of like it is your time. Interesting. Bottom of the deck. I've got the Fox, shadow work. There are no shadows without light. Remember, I did say at the beginning, we can be our own demons as well. Don't let negative thinking stop you from manifesting. It feels like what is a golden opportunity here. Because I think that there is the potential for you to really feel good and celebrate and find some achievement in October. It's beautiful. I hope you enjoyed the reading. If you did, please do like, share and subscribe. I hope it's a wonderful month for you, Scorpio, and I will see you next time. Thank you.